Hi guys, my name is Niels Engelbrecht from Lightland Studio and this is my beautiful wife Jana Engelbrecht.
Hi guys, today we will be giving you a tutorial on high-speed sync and we will be taking you through all the equipment that we use to create these stunning images. So we are very excited to introduce to you the Godox lighting system. Niels is actually one of the proud brand ambassadors for this wonderful brand. So Niels, let's start. What is high-speed sync?
So, Johanna, most flash lighting equipment only allows you to sync at a shutter speed of 200 or below. So that is why the high-speed sync allows you to actually sync at over 1,000 or 2, 3, 4, 8 thousandths of a second, which can allow you to shoot at a very lower f-stop.
Well, that's wonderful. So that means that you can now shoot at a low aperture without having to compromise your depth of field by just adjusting your shutter speed.
Yeah, and with your adjusting your shutter speed, you can control your ambient light to get the beautiful dark backgrounds, but still have your beautiful in-depth depth of field photo. So Jana, let's quickly show them what products we use. Okay, so what we have here is two systems. The first system is the Godox AD200 Pro. And do you want to introduce to them this one?
Yes, this is my baby. It's the AD600.
Yeah, this is a beautiful light. This has got 600 watt power, which is when shooting in outdoors, it's amazing. I normally use these little ones for indoors or even when I want to travel light, the AD200 is my guy.
Yeah, these ones are also actually great to replace your normal flash.
So I do a combination of lighting setups with this setup. This will be my main light, which I just have over the couple, and then this little light I will normally have as a back flash that can create some nice lighting setup, especially when you're shooting in the evenings. Also, what I like about the Godox setup is this little flash kit softbox that we have here. You guys will see this is what it comes with. It's an interchangeable bulb. This bulb comes with the kit, with the AD200, and you can actually use it as a studio flash with this softbox. What is nice about it, it just slips into this one, and you can just quickly tie it down. Now, this is the magic. This can change your normal flash head into a beautiful studio softbox setup by just unclicking this. Put it on here. There you go. Now you have a beautiful flash with a softbox. Easy, it's lightweight, and you can actually use it indoors or outdoors. And that's one of the key things about this Godox setup that I love. What do you love, Jana?
I love the fact that it's portable and that it's small, especially for ladies that don't want to walk around with a heavy light or heavy equipment, or maybe don't have an assistant with them. They can actually take that and it will work just as well.
Here is a quick example to show you guys how we use this little light in the field. As you can see, it's very easy to set up.
Get my manual focus ready.
Perfect, got it all. And the high speed sync on these photos is just amazing. So with this AD200 Pro kit, you get this beautiful adapter that you can just slide in here on the bottom. Now you can put it on any studio stand at any angle, and that is super light. Easy, especially for the ladies.
Yeah.
Shooting indoors, it's a breeze. You can just, I sometimes have my assistant just holding it for me in different directions. And yeah, this is a very nice one. This one we normally use for outdoors to give you a little bit more power.
Yeah.
600 watts is a lot of power. And if you guys can see the bulb in the front, it's got a very big light. just giving you enough power shooting in sunlight, yeah. So now you can shoot into the sun on a shallow depth of field without having to burn your highlights in the background.
Yeah, that's great.
That is amazing. We're going to show you some examples of how we did it and yeah, just have a look.
Yeah, Let's show you these babies in action.
Yes.
Okay, so this is a great practical example. In the image on the left, you can see I literally just used the Godox light as a fill-in, and then the image on the right was taken about 30 seconds later, and all I did was adjust my shutter speed and adjust the power of the light.
So the high-speed sync system allows you to up your shutter speed so that you can still have the beautiful shallow depth of field without having, because sometimes when you're shooting on f1.8 or f2.8, you have to compromise and you burn out your highlights in the background.
Yeah, well, sometimes you want it to create a more natural light feel, like the image on the left, and then sometimes you want a little bit more drama, like the image on the right.
So this is a very nice example. So we're going to show you some more examples. You guys can see this image is taken with a very low aperture in the nice depth of field in the background. The next image you guys can see, I did a different kind of style with a high f-stop. This is the difference between shooting on high speed scene and with a high f-stop.
Okay, so here's another example. This image was taken just after sunset. We still had a lot of ambient light, so I literally just used my Godox light for a little bit of fill in on her face. And then the next image was taken again a few seconds later, just by bringing in the husband and then upping my shutter speed and upping the power of the light to create that beautiful, dramatic background.
Yeah, so the one thing about high-speed sync is you lose a bit of power. Yeah. So if you have to shoot into the sun with high-speed sync, you have to pretty much put your light on 1/1. Or just allow your flash to come a bit closer to your subject. But as you guys can see on the image, it's beautiful. The first image that you can see, it's almost like a natural light look.
Yes.
If you want to shoot into the sun, that's a lot of backlight coming from the back. So by just using the high-speed sync system, you can now get that beautiful drama effect in the background. So the best thing about it is you don't have to change your f-stop anymore. Where if you're shooting at the shutter speed of 200, you have to shoot at f/18 to on full power to get that beautiful dramatic look. But then everything is in focus, the light, the background, the clouds, everything is in focus. But with a high speed sync, you can shoot over 1/8000th of a second, but still shoot on a low aperture.
Yeah, so you can get that nice depth of field.
Yeah. So here are some more examples. So this is a great example of a behind the scenes photo that we took on our wedding. As you guys can see, the Godox 8600 is just a little bit to the right. But the next image will show you still having my beautiful out of focus background, shallow depth of field with a high speed sync. And I just love the lighting on that bride. Here is an even better example. I was shooting this shot on f/1.4. with a Sigma Art lens, getting that beautiful depth of field with the Godox light just inches above the bride's head. And that's what I love about the Godox system. They are very small, versatile, and easy to use.
And obviously, all these shots are taken into the light. So the light will be behind our subjects, and that's what we want, because then you can actually use the Godox light to fill in.
So Jana and I love to shoot into the sun. With the Godox system, allows you to actually get some amazing images by just filling it in. As you guys can see, my subject is lit up with the 8600, and you guys can see the beautiful drama effect in this shot. If we zoom into this photo, you guys can see the shallow depth of field that this image was shot on, and this is what I love about the high-speed sync system from Godox.
Yes, and also this replaces your reflector. So you cannot create these same images by using a reflector.
Like Jana said, we don't shoot with reflectors anymore because the lighting is consistent. You don't have to worry about wind, and it's just straight on
beautiful.
Yeah,
and you don't need someone to hold a reflector.
Yeah.
So you actually can just put your light on a stand and take it with you wherever you go.
The high-speed sync system is not only for outdoors. We also use it indoors. We do a lot of corporate profiles at Light Lounge Studio, and our clients not always have ideal locations to shoot. So we use the high-speed sync system, shooting on a very low, shallow depth of field. And you guys can see here's a few examples of some of the clients that we've shot. This photo was taken on a low f/1.8 with an 85mm. And as you guys can see, you have no idea. This was inside the bar area. So your client don't need to have beautiful space to shoot at.
Yeah, so you're actually creating your own backdrop or shallow depth of field.
Yeah.
So you don't necessarily need to take a backdrop to a corporate client.
Next, we're going to talk about the trigger. This is an amazing trigger. You can add 5 up to 6 lights on one trigger by just putting them on different channels. I did a shoot the other day where I had 5 lighting setups on one trigger. and each individual light you can set by just pressing on the side and turning this little button, and your lighting will change from 1/1 to 1/128.
Yeah, so that means no more running around between your lights and where you're actually standing. You can adjust everything on there. And like Niela said, each individual light can be adjusted on there. Yeah. So
we
that's
just
a great system.
Put every light onto a different channel, A, B, C, D, E. And you can just go on to this side, just press channel D, adjust
channel.
The lighting power, which helps a lot, especially when you're shooting weddings and you want to adjust your back flash from the other side. You don't have to run all the way across the dance floor to do that.
Or turn certain lights off that you don't want to trigger in that photo.
So yeah, thank you so much guys for watching this little tutorial. If you have any questions regarding high-speed sync, feel free to contact us, Jana Engelbrecht Photography, on Instagram, Niels Engelbrecht Photography, or just pop a mail to the Light Lounge Studio.
Yeah.
We'll see you guys next time. Thank you.